Subcup God and everybody else. And listen, that's a good game, man. Gonna buy Microsoft Flight Simulator for Xbox. Wait, that's on Xbox? I didn't know that. I thought that was like PC only Flight Simulator. Or is it like a different game, Microsoft Flight Simulator? You tell me. So no more Hunt Showdown? Oh, it's only next gen. Ah, I see, I see. I see. So, today, ladies and gentlemen, for those who are watching this live, that are in chat right now, or for those who watch it back on YouTube or Instagram, welcome to yet another live cooking show, episode 89. We're almost at episode 100, almost a big 100. And today, at episode 89, we got quite the summery meal, if you ask me. Today, I'll be making a nice dish with some spicy garlic shrimps. And we're gonna eat that with some rice and green beans and grilled tomatoes. And I also got some other stuff, it's like coriander and spices. It's gonna be delicious. I could see you liking Enlisted though, it's pretty realistic. I never played it, Cup God, but I already like it. I saw Smail play it a lot on stream, so I already know that I like it, even though I haven't played it yet. Just the fact that the TTK is really low in that game just appeals me a lot. Because yeah, for the last almost 3 years, I've been playing Battlefield 5, and we all know that it takes like 2 magazines to kill a guy. So yeah, I've been I hope that the new Battlefield has a lower TTK than Battlefield 5. I'm sure it will. I think they're, from what I've seen, it's like what we know Battlefield for again. So let's hope that the TTK will be the same with that. Anyway, let's get started. Ingredients on the right. Lovely. Let's flip this camera and have a closer look at them. Ingredients hype. So I got a lot of stuff on my plate. First off, the shrimps. Yes, we got those. Now for the shrimps, we're gonna marinate them with some ginger syrup. It's also for the tomatoes, by the way. And I got some chili powder. I got some cayenne pepper powder. It's gonna be a little bit spicy. But to reduce that spiciness a bit, I'm gonna add some lemon juice to that. So here's the lemon. And we're also gonna need some garlic for that and olive oil. Olive oil is not in the screen right now. The bottle I have is too big. That's what she said. It's good the graphics are decent, yes. Well, it's more, for me it's always about gameplay anyway. If it has good graphics too, then that's a bonus for me. But for me, the most important thing is the gameplay. What's up, Barb? I'm gonna lurk. I'm starting my stream at 8. All right, let's go, Barb. If you started sooner than that, let's say 45 minutes from now, if you do that, I can raid you, Barb. We can't have Barb here without showing the Barb chicken. I still have to come up with a nice, decent text that comes along in chat when we do the Barb chicken. I thought you meant like 20, as in 8 o'clock, but you meant 20 minutes. Perfect, Barb. Perfect. We'll be freaking raiding you then. There's that. We don't have to worry about that anymore. Dumbing in coming with a 6 month subscription, resubscribing to the chicken farm. 6 months in a row, currently on a 2 month streak. Dubbing, Thank you so much, Dubbing. Let's go. But I want to, Barb. Dubbing, you legend. While we're at it, let's just take out the dubbing chicken as well. You know, that's what the chickens are for. Let's go. Buzzing for life, it's dubbing for life. And since he's here too, Cup God. Dubbing, look at Cup God's name. He changed it to 69. Cup God's chicken, exclamation mark, Ethan. Don't fear, Ethan the medic is here. There, we had all the chickens in the screen right now. Love it. So back to the ingredients. I got some tomatoes over here. These will be marinated with the same thing as the shrimps. Then we're gonna boil some green beans. I got some green beans over here. Maybe I'm gonna stir fry them a little bit after that. Maybe with some sesame. It's not in the ingredients list, but just started thinking about that. Would be nice. So yeah, green beans. Gotta have some veggies along with your food, you know. And the rice, we're just gonna boil that with some curry, yellow curry powder. So it will have flavor, extra flavor, but also it will become kind of a yellow rice. So that's that. And to finish everything off, I got some coriander over here. I still haven't added a new chicken arc. I've been quite busy for the last couple of days dubbing. So no chicken arc, still no new chicken arc. Alright, let's get started. So first off, I'm gonna start boiling water for both the rice and the green beans. So let's fill those pans with some water and start boiling that. I also preheated my oven at 220 degrees Celsius, so that's pretty warm. Pretty high temperature. Hope all is well over at Dubbing's. Senor Stewie. Still number one on the leaderboard. As almost always. He already let me know I really don't want to win another season. But you're not making it easy for me. You're just really good at unlocking chicken arcs, Dubbing. So, I'm gonna start off by making the marinade. So I need a bowl. This will be for the shrimps and for the tomatoes. Dubbing was eaten alive by the guard dogs. Poor Dubbing. He forgot to take out that bacon from his pocket. Also with enlisted, when you're out of ammo, you're out of ammo. There's no way for you to restock on your ammo, like a support player or maybe some kind of crate or station nearby. So, ginger syrup. Slightly spicy, the ginger syrup. Not that much, it's mainly really sweet. I'm also gonna add olive oil to that. I don't have olive oil anymore. Alright. Then I guess we have to go with some regular sunflower oil. Dubbing did the wolf and it ate Cup God's chickens. Oh, god damn it. And then he lost 10k straight away trying to lure out the fox. Fox was still hiding. Damn. Dubbing is after all the chicken games right now. Cup God is like really buzzing, really. Let's add some cayenne pepper to that. And some chili powder. Alright. We don't need those anymore. Put that away. Then garlic. Decent amount of garlic. I got 3 cloves right now. Oh, the jackpot is empty again. We had the jackpot the other day. The winners were Fractured and Yanusko. So we're back at 2% with the jackpot. And Dubbing just defeated the Angry Ant. I am planning on, you know, all those monsters from the Monster Hunt. Like the Angry Ant or the Scary Sheep. Or, you know, I'm thinking about creating avatars for those too. We got the Scary Sheep and the Angry Ant and the Panic Peacock and the Jackpot Jackal. So I'm thinking about creating avatars for those as well. Expanding the chicken farm. So I'm gonna chop up this garlic. If you don't want it to be all that garlicky, you can reduce the amount of cloves. Like have 1 or 2 instead of 3. I'm absolutely a sucker for garlic. Every time we eat a lot of garlic here, I sleep on the couch. At night. She can't handle it, you know? What did you think of the first look of gameplay? Well, it looked like Battlefield the way I used to know Battlefield Dubbing, and that's really a good thing. Not so sure about that system where you can like change your attachments of your weapons, but I guess, you know, Battlefield usually it has a lot of maps where there's like different areas where there's close combat or long range combat, and that all on the same map. So I guess, you know, when you're in the open fields, you want a scope with a little bit more zoom. But when you get to those close combat areas, it's nice that you can switch it to like a red dot or something. But I don't know, I have to, it kind of depends on the balance of everything, you know. If it has a good balance, all the gadgets and the weapons, I guess I'm cool with it. But I'm just afraid that if it's not, everybody who plays the game kind of uses the same guns and gadgets, kind of what you see in Call of Duty a lot. And then, you know, they just released a new gun and then 4 days later they already patching it again. That's my only worry. I also had worries about things with the specialist and such, but from what I've seen from the gameplay, the guy with the wingsuit and the grapple hook, it didn't look like anything stupid really. I think I'm gonna enjoy using that wingsuit a lot. And as you saw in the gameplay reveal, it is not like you can stay in the air like non-stop when you use that wingsuit. It doesn't appear like that. You always have the gravity pulling you down, but you can like really travel more distance before you get to the ground than, for example, with a parachute. So it looks good. The game is pretty hardcore, no third person. You're talking about Enlisted Cup, God. On the 28 players, that's a large skill. Yes, but that's only for PC and next gen. So not for the old gen. The old gen will just have 64. And I'm cool with that. You know, I mean, I always played Battlefield with 64. So I don't feel necessary yet to get myself like a next-gen console yet. So I think that's a good decision by EA and DICE to release it on the old-gen as well. Because, you know, a lot of people might want a new-gen, but they simply can't get one. because it's so heavily underproduced. So we got ourselves a nice little marinade. Now I'm gonna go to the tomatoes. Let's see this camera angle quickly. Can you guys still see it? A little bit. Let's do it like this then. Yes, perfect. So the tomatoes, real simple. Need to expand my chat again. There you go. NextGen also has bigger maps. Well, I'm. That's like, how much bigger, you know, or how much smaller will this old gen map be, you know? Is it like really significant smaller or slightly? I wonder. I found one at Curious PC World. They sell out pretty quickly. Yeah, they're heavily underproduced. Like, there are more people wanting it than they actually like fabricate it in the factories. I don't know if that's the same deal with PlayStation 5 though. You guys tell me, I don't know if that, but I know it's the case with Xbox. So these just go into half. Actually, I think these are quite large. I'm only gonna use two tomatoes instead of three, otherwise it will be too much food for two persons. So. Lot bigger last gen size of Hamada. Well, that's still pretty big, right? I guess if you only can play it with 64 players, you don't really want to have those big of a maps, you know? You can't, otherwise you'll be running around without being in combat a lot because the maps are too big. So I guess it's good. But yeah, like, I don't really care about all that if I look at the gameplay. I mean, and they know exactly what triggers the Battlefield fans, you know? Like in the gameplay reveal, you saw this guy again with the quad bike, this time with C4. He triggers the C4 when his teammate launches it into the chopper. That's what we want to see, you know? NextGen is like Hamada 5 times. Ooh, that's really big. Got to go for dinner. Got fish. Alright, Copgut. Bon appetit, sir. Enjoy your foods. Fish, really healthy and nice, quite summery too. Love it. Only 4 specialists to start on release, so they kind of like release new specialists as they go along then. So dropping some of that marinade on the tomatoes, and we're gonna pre-bake those in the oven for a bit, and later we'll add the shrimps. Now I had a little problem when I was at the supermarket to buy the shrimps because I wanted those like intact. Well, they already took off the legs here and the, what do you call it, the mustache, I don't know how to call it, but they're the only version I could get where they were still intact were pre-cooked. So these are actually already like pre-cooked, so I only need to heat these up. You can also eat them cold in a salad. That's mainly what they're for, this type of product. But yeah, I'm gonna have them heated up, so I'll add these later to the tomatoes in the oven just to preheat them. Copcut, you have a great night and enjoy your meal. I still have to take off their skin though, and those last part of their legs, we don't want that. So we're gonna start doing that. In the meantime, I'm looking to my left and water started to boil a bit, so I'm about to add the rice to that while I peel these shrimps. quite a process. So no battle royale or campaign, just all multiplayer maps. Oh, in neither of those cases I'm disappointed really. Like, I personally, I'm kind of done with battle royale games. I mean, it was fun, but it's kind of like, there's too much now. And whenever there's a new one, it doesn't feel like renewing, you know, it feels like, oh, just another battle royale. And also, I don't think Battlefield should have one, because it's not, it's just not Battlefield, you know. And the campaign, of course, it's nice to play a campaign if it's any good, but yeah, Battlefield is not necessarily known for great campaigns. Not that they're bad, but you know, it's not like wow, you know. And it costs, I bet it costs a lot of money to create campaigns. So I think they did well by not creating a campaign and just use that money that they would have spent on creating a campaign on putting everything in their multiplayer, you know? So, and if I look at my gaming history, of course, you play the campaign maybe twice. Maybe you play it twice. But that's about it, you know? Maybe a third time on hardcore. But yeah, after that, it's just non-stop multiplayer, right? So I don't think, for me at least, like, it should necessarily have a campaign. I, for example, I never buy games that only have single player. If it doesn't have a multiplayer, I'm not interested. Well, unless it's Mass Effect. Big fan of the series here. That's about the only science fiction game I like to play. Well, and Astroneer. I like Astroneer too. Right, so the water has started to boil on my left, so I'm gonna add the rice to that. That has to cook for 10 minutes. Then I have to drain the water, put on the lid, and let it rest for another 10 minutes. So that means our meal will be ready in 20 minutes from now. Do you not remove the spine? They already did that for me. You mean the intestines? These are the spineless ones. Dubbing. Well, not the spine, but I don't know how to call it. Look, they already, see? I don't know how they did it. I think they like breed it a special way. So these are not, these don't live in free in nature, you know? Yeah, these don't have that. It was on the package too, actually. But if you buy those shrimps at the fish market, you do have to do that, because you don't want to eat their poop, you know? I don't know how they did it with these ones, but it was on the package, so. Generic modifications. Scary, if you think about it. Humans trying to be like God or something. Oh, this one doesn't have eyes. See that? He lost his eyes. It's a blind shrimp. Okay, I got three more to go. What are you up to dubbing today? Are you, watching the European Championships? like football, or you're not like a fan or paying attention to that at all. At least you leave some of the shell on. Well, unfortunately, not all of them have their tail. Some already like lost their tail. But then again, these are kind of cheap shrimps, so don't expect quality products, really. Like this one still has his tail on. This one didn't. So, not sure what that's about. I think that's just because they were like the cheaper ones. You don't watch it? Me neither. I did watch a little bit of the last evening's match between the Netherlands and Ukraine. But I didn't even know half of the Dutch players, man. No tail, no head. Yeah, it varies over here. Some don't have eyes, some don't have tail. Some have neither. Hallo, Blaze. Can we get an exclamation mark Blaze in chat? Maybe Blaze should do it himself. Bring out the Blaze chicken. Hallo, comrade Blaze. Blaze is really busy with his exams. He's gotta graduate. You gotta, Blaze, you gotta. You have to. That's an order, soldier. Thank you, dubbing. So let's marinate these shrimps as well. I'm just gonna call them lazy shrimps, because they're already pre-baked and cooked. You don't really have to clean them, except for their skin, that is. Hello, comrade. I like how you added the G to hello to make it sound more like Russian. Hello. Hello, comrade Jamona. How are you today? I'm good. How are you? Nom 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 nom. Blazy shrimps or lazy shrimps? Well, maybe both. They're the blazy lazy shrimps. The spicy shrimp is a good Caribbean dish as well. Well, dude, I love Caribbean food. I am going to balance it out a little bit, though, by adding some lemon juice. Having a quick look at the tomatoes. Looking good. Now that's a good name. You mean Blazy Lazy Shrimp. Next thing you know, when I log into Xbox, in my friend list appears Blazy Lazy Shrimp. Like, oh yeah, that's Blaze. I know who that is. Another thing you should get, we just added for Cup God, because he's always heavy breathing in the Xbox party. We added this one. He actually requested that himself, after dubbing mentioned it. It should be a command. Oh, I do not want the seed of the lemon here. So when we do like exclamation mark Blaze, it shows your chicken, but it also says it's lazy blazy shrimp. We can do that, no problem. All right. Quickly stirring my rice a little bit. Shrimps marinated and ready. We'll add that to the tomatoes later. Now, let's put that aside for a bit, because we still need to cut all the green beans. But the command has to be something about you. I agree on that, yeah. So what, like, defines Blaze? I'm thinking right now. Something that really defines Blaze a lot. Copcat's heavy breathing and Dubbing's buzzing mic. He loves Russian, yeah. That's a fact right there. It's Comrade Blaze. He kills grizzly bear with bare hands. Something like that. How many tests you still have to do, Blaze? Like, how many exams left? Which courses? Russian roulette mute. Nog 5? Oké. Is er nog een bepaald vak waar je tegenop kijkt? Ik veel wiskunde of zo. The wolf is still on cooldown, Dubbing. Niet echt. Easy peasy. Ja. Dat ga ik onthouden dat je dat zei. Voor als je zakt. Ik zeg, oh, ik dacht dat je zei dat het easy was. Ga ik je daar heel lang mee pesten. So Dubbing said he really doesn't want to win another season. But yet again, he's constantly playing all the Chicken Chat games. Dubbing wants to go on a monster hunt. Let me join that real quick. Did you already wear your farm fresh t-shirt, Dubbing? Or did you, like, seal it and then right now it's on your wall, like some kind of trophy? You know, you got those people, they buy really expensive shoes, but they're never wearing it. It's more of a showcase item in their living room, you know? The Mad Mouse. Yes, we defeated the Mad Mouse. Let's go. So, green beans. Ready. Let me clean my knife real quick. There. I don't put the knife in the dishwasher. That's not good for the blade. So I always clean it with some hot water. Some hot water? Oh, by the way, I wanted to show you guys. Look. Look at these beautiful cherries. Who's gonna pop a cherry? fits good as it is from the US. Oh yeah, you had like the 4XL, right? that's regular XL. or like, no, not regular XL, that's like That's 20 XL for European people. 4 XL. Like, literally everything over there is bigger. Everything. So I'm gonna boil these beans. Got the rice going on there, on the back side. Now let's add the beans to the watsa. We have to wait until it boils again, then we're gonna boil them for about 4 minutes. Then we'll drain them. Maybe after that stir fry them a little bit, or I'll just put them alongside the tomatoes and the shrimps in the oven. I think that's better. I think that's actually better. Oh. Also, it's bloody hot today. It's gonna be even hotter tomorrow. I don't know about the weather in Belgium and the UK, dubbing Blaze. So you gotta keep hydrated. I'm gonna take a brief moment here to tell you guys something. So, some of you might have noticed that there aren't a lot of Battlefield streams, or rather, none. It really has to do with the fact that I'm really I'm just exhausted by playing that game. I still like the game, but it's just, I can't find the motivation for now. I'm not saying like forever. Like, I can't find the motivation right now to play that game. Really has to do with the fact that I've played it for so many goddamn hours. Kind of, you know, like that. I don't wanna. On a side note though, after seeing the Battlefield 2042 reveal trailer, I do feel like playing Battlefield 4 again. You know, it gave me those vibes again. So you guys can expect a Battlefield 4 stream soon. But Battlefield 5, I think that might take some time for me to, feeling motivated again to play that game. I just checked the other day, I got almost 1400 hours of Battlefield 5. So at one point you really especially when there's no new content, you kind of play the same thing over and over again. I just don't feel it anymore, you know? Play Battlefield 1. Like, Battlefield 1, even though I think it's a really good game, apart from Hardline, of course, if you don't count in Hardline, Battlefield 1 was my least favorite Battlefield of all Battlefields, even though I think it's a great game. So I won't be playing that, sorry. Yeah, tomorrow it's gonna be 30 degrees or more, yeah. Over here they said 31. But you're to the south, Blaze. So I reckon it's gonna be slightly warmer where you live. It's got crept too many persistent problems. That too, yeah, I agree. I think in going back to Battlefield 1. I was thinking the same, but then with Battlefield 4, you know. That's like a cure. Oh, you don't want to play Battlefield 5 anymore? You know what you should do, says Dubbing. Play some Call of Duty. After that, you immediately go back. Makes sense, you know. Alright, let's have a look at the
tomatoes.
Yes, coming along nicely, so I need to do like this and like this. Alright, let's flip that a little bit. So let's take out the tomatoes here. Ooh, sizzling. And let's add those shrimps to that. Yes. What's up, Kami? All is well. It's quite hot over here, Kami. But apart from that, all is good. How are things on your end? On your side of the pond, Kami? Tell me all about it. Tuning in live from Montana. I've really been trying to drop by at your streams, Kami. Not necessarily because I have to, but mostly because I want to. But every time you're live, I'm not like not being able to watch. You gotta either change your sleep schedule, Kami, or change your streaming schedule just for me, you know, just for me. Hot as in spicy or really hot? It's 95 degrees over here. I'm not sure how much Celsius that is. I'm not sure. I don't know the conversion out of my head, really. You don't have to do anything for me, bro. I just joined. Yeah, but I want to, Kami. I want to. Maybe I'll start getting up at 5 a.m. my time so I can stream in your day. Yes, sounds perfect. Because I think we're like 8 or 9 hours apart. Oh, wait, Montana, that's more to the west of the states. So I guess we're either 8 or 9 hours apart, you and me. You know? That's around 32? Alright. Damn, isn't that like really warm for Montana? Wait, what's your time right now, Kami? Is it 10:20 or 9:20? Doesn't stop me from coming to see my Jamona. Heaven sent chicken. It's 10:20. Okay, so we're 8 hours apart, you mean. Over here, it's 6:20 p.m. So, we're 8 hours apart then. The funny thing is, over here, we don't say, like, for example, when it's evening, you guys would say 10 p.m., right? We would do it like this. This is 10 in the evening for us. And like this, it's 10 in the morning. Weird, right? So, let me drain the green beans. I got the green beans here. So I'm gonna drain that. I can hear an Xbox message. I'll check it out later. Do not interrupt Jamona when he's streaming from his kitchen, you bastards. That's why I'm set to not disturb. Early morning streams. I want to see you sit there, Kami, with a big, big ass coffee mug. Because you're gonna need that in the morning, you know? I'm setting a target to beat, then I will stop. What are you. Wait. Blaze, Dubbing, what's going on? Dubbing is gonna beat somebody up? What the hell? 22 for me is military time. Yeah, well, over here that's how we kind of say the clockwork, you know? That's just the AM, PM, 12, 24. That's one of the few things, actually, the way like they do the AM, the PM. That's one of the few things I think is better than we do it. Like everything else, like miles instead of kilometers or... ounces and pounds instead of grams and kilograms. I all hate that they do it differently. But the like the 12, like the AM, the PM, I wish we had that too, you know? Because you say 10 o'clock in the evening. Why do you type out 2200, you know? So, there's a time that you will be playing the next card, if that's going to be really good. I need to say this in the camera, Blaze. There was a time where I did that, when I first saw the trailer and the gameplay from Call of Duty Modern Warfare, like the last game. And I was like, after a decade of not buying Call of Duty games, I was like, okay, this looks like the way I used to like Call of Duty. So I went ahead, I bought the game, I did the campaign, I did the multiplayer, and like the first couple of months I was like, yeah, this is everything I want from Call of Duty. But then slightly, little by little, it started to change. We get purple tracer bullets, killer bats, killer crows, hot dog heads, strap-ons. I don't know what the fuck they added to that game, but it's nothing like they... Because before it got released, they were like, yeah, we're gonna go like more tactical modern warfare shooter. But look at it now, man. It's more of a Muppet Show than fucking Fortnite. So I kind of felt like deceived. So at that point, I was like, I'm never ever, no matter how it looks, I'm never ever going to buy a Call of Duty game for the rest of my life. So there's your answer, Blaze. I'm not going to fall for it again. Even if they make a new Call of Duty and they release some kind of milsim trailer for it, you're like, oh, milsim. I'm not going to fall for it, because half a year later, you got hot dog hats, pink outfits, invisible cloaks, bats that kill your opponents. No, not falling for it again. I'm not gonna buy that game, no matter how it looks. Never gonna buy a Call of Duty for the rest of my life. So I hope that's a good answer, Blaze. Battlefield being crossplay, I'll be up at 3 a.m. to play with you guys. Nice. Well, they're still not sure about that. I wonder. And if there's gonna be crossplay, I bet it's only gonna be between old gens and like new gens and PC, you know. And I know you're on PC, Kami, so I don't know if we'll be able to do that. But if we are able, we're gonna do it definitely. I'll do the same, man. I'll stay up late or early. I wake up early to do the same, man. I need to catch up with chat a little bit here. Normal Americans look at me like, what the fuck did you just say? Because you prefer military clocks? So you're kind of a loner on that, Kami. 5:30 is usually wake-up time for my fight. Oh, so you're kind of used to that. At 3 a.m. Snake eaters get breaky? What? See, that's what killed PUBG. Paint balls and all that. Well, I don't know, Kami. From what I've seen, PUBG is still being played a lot. Mostly by the diehards. Not a lot of new players, of course. I need to take off the rice. I need an extra towel. We need to drain that. Un momento, por favor. So, here's my laptop. Here's my sink. There is my groin as well, for those who love to see that. Little Jamona groin hype. So, let's drain it. Ah! That's freaking hot, dude. Let's drain it. I hope 2042 brings no battle royale. It's not on my wish list, to say the least. I really don't care about that. I said it earlier before you came in chat, Kami. We talked about it a little bit, and basically what I said is like I'm kind of done with battle royale games. So I also think like Battlefield shouldn't be having a battle royale, really. I mean, yeah. Just focus on having a good multiplayer, you know? So you're not the only one who thinks like that, Kami. Corona's killing you in Modern Warfare. No, you're not the only one who's burnt out on battle royales. I still play PUBG occasionally, but that really has to do with the fact that I really love the more, well, I wouldn't want to say realistic because the graphics look far from realistic, but I mean more like when you play it with friends, more of the gameplay, you know, the way you play that game. Now it's like doesn't have weird weapons or anything, you know. It's more like one thing, for example, I really like about PUBG is the way how the gunplay is. How it really needs. It's not like when you play it for the first time, you can immediately properly fire a weapon. You know, you really gotta learn how to control it first. Maybe not all weapons in that game, but most, you know, it's significantly different than other shooters. And especially when you play it with friends, you kind of do more like tactical wise, low key, you know, maybe sometimes even stealthy. And like the thing you see with other battle royales, everybody just kind of runs around crazy, you know, grappling, hooking around, or jumping off skyscrapers like you do in Apex without even getting slightly damaged by it, even though you just jumped off 40 floors, a 40 floor building, you know. PUBG is more like more of the realistic style battle royale. That's what I still like to play every now and then, but every now and then, it's not that I play it every week. The thing I'm really hooked onto right now, Kami, and actually, no, that game is really good on PC. It's called Hunt Showdown. Like, that's my... Hunt Showdown is somewhere here, deep in my heart. It's like, really... Because it's unique, you know? It's a really unique game. It has some similarities with Escape from Tarkov. Like, slightly. But apart from that, it's pretty unique. You can't really compare it with anything. And it's such a... interesting game. I can imagine that there are a lot of people who do not like the game because it's really slow paced. They might say, oh, the guns feel chunky, bit clumsy and such, but it's such a good game. Battlefield is made for multiplayer, yes, Blaze. And they should focus solely on that, if you ask me. I'm kind of sad though that they didn't make a campaign for you know, that costs a lot of money, Kami, to create a campaign. And they just decided, no, the money that we would have used to create a campaign, we're going to just pump it into the multiplayer. I have to get going a little bit. Hunt Showdown, I never played, but from watching you play it, it looks really good. Well, there are mixed opinions about that. I had people say like, when are you going to shoot somebody? This looks boring. Because, you know, you got a lot of quiet moments where you just sneak around. Nothing from the eye, if you watch it as a viewer, it appears that not a lot is going on. It might seem boring, but that's just me and my team trying to be stealthy and as quiet as possible. Because we don't want to alert any nearby players. Because that game is completely built around sound. You can literally run through the woods and step on a branch. And the branch cracks, and that cracking sound can be heard by nearby enemy players, and they're like, oh, there's somebody in the woods. And like the 3D surround, like if you got a good headset, they really did that well. You can literally hear where somebody is based off sound. You don't really have to see the guy, you know. Top-notch game, if you ask me. And the fun thing about it is you can play for 10 minutes straight. Everything is quiet. Of course, you knock down some zombies and monsters, but everything apart from that, it's quiet. And you almost think like, oh, I think we're alone in the lobby right now. And then all of a sudden, shit goes down, you know, shit's hit the fan and gunshots everywhere and things exploding. It's like, it's a high tension game. I like the PvP and hunt aspect. Yeah, it's like PvP, PvE. So it's like a mix. You can be like totally focused on killing the monsters and zombies, but you always have to keep in mind that you also have to be careful for other players. So, and also the other way around, when you're fighting other players, you also have to worry that when you're fighting another player, you don't get smacked in the head by a zombie or something. You know, it's interesting. Love games that are based on sound, or at least a lot of it. Well, then this game, I bet at the design table before they started creating the game, Kami, they were like, okay, we're gonna make a game that, most importantly, the sound, and everything else came after that. I think that's how they started off creating this game. I love Minecraft the most. It's a creative game. It's a good game, Blaze. Like Warzone can make you get a lot better if you have a good headset. I think with a lot of games nowadays, like audio engineering has become really good in gaming industry. So I immediately noticed, I play Hunt Showdown with Janusko a lot. At first he didn't have the headset he has now. He bought the same one as I have. But I've been playing Hunt Showdown with him before he got that headset. His skills gone up like times 20 after he got the new headset. And he's like, whoa, I can see what you mean now. Like everything is so much clearer. Let's get back to the cooking. We're talking a lot about stuffies here. So in the meantime, we also have to worry about getting our bellies filled. So these beans are boiled. I'm going to stir fry them in a little bit. Let's add a little bit of coriander here to the tomatoes and shrimps. We'll use the rest for garnishing. If you don't like coriander, which I can imagine not a lot of people like it, or a lot of people don't like it, use parsley. Do you ever steam your veggies? Well, not a lot. Sometimes. Sometimes. Right now I got my oven set to the grill function. So I'm grilling the tomatoes in there along with the shrimps right now. Steamed vegetables, oh my lord, that's good though. You love shrimp? Yeah, me too. It's the only shellfish I really eat. Honestly, I do not like the other ones, like oysters or mussels. Ugh. Do you eat the shrimp heads and eyes too? No, that's just for the looks. Oh, and Kami, by the way, in here, the marinade for the shrimps and the tomatoes. That's oil, ginger syrup, chili powder, cayenne pepper powder, lots of garlic, and what else did we put in there? Oh, that's it. Yeah. Right, so I'm briefly gonna put this back in the oven. For about 5 minutes. And in those 5 minutes, I'm gonna stir fry the green beans a bit. First I need to clean up a little bit. It's kind of messy over here. Let's take a grain of rice. Let me show myself, otherwise you guys were just looking at an empty cutting board. That's not really interesting. Might as well look at my ugly face, right? How I'm sweating in the kitchen right now, because it's freaking hot. Ran out of my shop. Don't worry about it, Kami. You don't have to do that, man. You don't have to do that. Like, that's just a bonus. As a matter of fact, it's not even... The only reason why I got myself affiliated is because in that way I could have the emotes. Of course, like, earning some money with your hobby is always great. But I know quite a lot of people who started off doing streams just because they were like, oh yeah, I'm gonna earn some money, you know? Well, in my opinion, if you do it for that reason, you already started off badly. I really only wanted to get the affiliation so I could could add my fancy chicken emotes, you know? So don't worry about that, Kami. Your face is quite ugly. I know, right? Oh, he's just joking. Shit. My mama told me I should do it because if I didn't help my friends, they would never help me. Well, there's a small portion of truth in there, yeah. But on the other hand, I think that's not... it is what friendship is about, but it shouldn't be the reason why you're friends. Am I saying that right? Is that understandable? There's a weapon on Warzone that has the name Necromancer. That's awesome. One day we will get you partner emotes. I don't think I'll ever reach that, Kami, to be honest. So let's get to my stove. Or however you call it. Let's move the camera here a little bit. Because we're gonna stir fry those green beans. So it's not being showed in my overlay, but I am going to add a little bit of sesame to that. It's gonna be nice. So let's heat that pan. Start heating it. Got a blurry camera, hold on. Let's clean that a little bit. Working on a whole new stream soon, like new overlays and such, Kami. Going to do a once a month podcast with streamer friends and other guests. Any particular subject for that podcast, Kami? Or like random subjects? Overlay, scenes, all of it. Oh. I must say, I really like that, that kind of dragon, that Asian dragon team going on. I really like that. Random polls from viewers. Could be conspiracies, food theories. Oh, I'll be down for the food theories. Definitely. Food talk with Kami and Comrade Jamona. We'll go talk about Russian ingredients. Like vodka. So how do you want your potatoes? With vodka. How would you like your meat? With vodka. How would you like your fish? Also vodka. Ice cream? Vodka. Basically, everything goes with vodka.
I would love to join that shit. So, heated up the pan, a little bit of sunflower oil, just a little bit. Let's add those beans. Sizzling.
Your Russian accent needs some work, comrade. Well, not everybody talks Russian like you do, Blaze or Kenny. My Russian accent not so good. I'm from Ukraine. We talk different.
You live in the US, the whole place is a conspiracy. That's why it's a good subject to talk about. One day in the next 2 years, I'm going to make a coffee shop near you. Oh shit, good luck with that. They're actually trying to reduce the amount of shops over here because they think it's too much. Where is my sesame?
I know Petrovsky.
The Pentagon is releasing official report about aliens and UFOs within the next 10 days. Oh, really? Oh, interesting. Well, I think if you look at the size of the universe, it would be naive to think that we're alone. If it's so big, you know, hardly can be that we're alone. If we'll ever meet them, though, I'm not sure about that. Alright, it's almost serving time, so I'm gonna grab some plates while you guys enjoy
the beautiful green beans.
Of course, the plates I want are in the highest cabinet. Now, I'm a pretty tall guy, but I still have to get a step to reach it. Apparently they are not hostile, right? So that's, if they were hostile, we already knew that they were here, right? Are you allowed to say that? Allowed to say what? About the aliens? They're on about Mexicans and Colombians and their new smuggling transports. So how do they smuggle it right now? Oh, Kami doesn't have to worry about that, Blaze. Kami lives in Montana. That's like the middle of nowhere, so they'll never find him. It would be the US government to say that UFOs are actually just third world tech that the richest country don't even have yet. Shit. Nice crispy green beans. Alright, we're getting close to the end, guys. Almost there. Also, I'm gonna turn off the oven right now and open the door. Because I don't want these shrimps to be overcooked or overbaked. That's disgusting, you know. But I am gonna keep them in the oven with the door slightly open, so, you know, they remain warm. Put that on low fire. Okay. So let's go to the plates. Aliens? Hello? How did a cooking show go from food to aliens? Came here, you fuck! So, first I'm gonna put on the rice. The rice! I'm grabbing it right now, bear with me. I always cook too much rice. Always too goddamn much. So I got pandan rice. I don't know if that's like translates the same. Oh, there goes my sieve. Fuck. It's broken, comrade. So to make it look fancy, I'm grabbing a mug. So I got a mug right here. Ish. I'm gonna fill that with the rice. Bear with me, guys. I'm doing this off cam for a second because the sieve broke down. There was still a bit of water in the pan. And I'm also gonna skip this song. Ah, that's better. Those beans look really good. Do those comes in a can? No, it's just from the vegetable store came. I did boil them first for like 4 minutes. And like we call that blanchere. I think in English you call it blanch. Blanch the veggies. So that's like cook it for a really short amount of time, like 4 minutes. And then after that, you drain the water and you stir fry that in the pan. So I got the rice right here. In the mug. No, didn't work. Okay, doesn't work with this type of rice, that's clear. I wanted to have like a tower, you know? Maybe the second one will work. We'll see. No, didn't work either. No, okay. I guess the fancy looks won't work today. We'll just do it with the spoon. Like that. I wanted to have like a tower, you know, like a tower of rice. But not today. Alright, so. Let's take out. Woo! Look at that. Ooh, la 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 la, that looks good. I need a scoopity whoop whoop. A nuke on a stealth plane for coke and money laundering. They got the fucking cartel got freaking stealth planes now. Maybe aliens have some good recipes. Like new ingredients. What about that? Like stuff we never ate before. That would be amazing. So, we got the garlicky tomatoes. I absolutely loved oven baked tomatoes. And of course, the shrimps. Tree, make sure there's an equal amount on each plate. Three for her, three for me. Five. It's five, two. How many left? Six. So three more each. That's good. You can really smell the lemon right now.
Aw, this one's little head fell off. Poor guy. Where's your head at? Where's your head at? Where's your head at? There you go. Make some room here. And last but not least, well, not last, because we also have something else we gotta add to that plate. First, let's add the green beans. Oh, it's maybe a little bit too much food right now for just two people. It's a big ass meal. Beans. Yeah, it's a bit too much. I got plus one. Who wants it? I got plus one meal, guys. No dog is gonna eat me. Abort mission! Then, finishing touch, some fresh coriander. Ooh. There you go. I'm quickly gonna yell upstairs that the food is ready. Give me a second. Oh man, it's so hot in my kitchen right now. You guys are talking Russian in chat right now. I don't understand that shit, guys. What's up, Lindsay? How are you, comrade Lindsay? I saw some nice photos of you and Dan traveling around. Were those e-bikes? Some extra beans for the missus. She loves the beans. It's a plate full of stuff, really. Don't worry about decorating or like presentation. Like all the different colors are nice enough. Let me quickly give this to the missus. She probably wants to take a photo for me. So one more time, guys. We got the shrimps with the garlic and the ginger and the oven baked tomatoes and the yellow rice with coriander and curry and the green beans briefly cooked and then stir fried with some sesame. Kind of a mess on the plate. That's all right. And Kami still thinks it looks good. Shit. I appreciate that, Kami. Damn, you want to titty milker. A titty milker? I want a titty milker. Do you eat shrimps, Lindsay? Or are you like completely vegetarian? No fish or shellfish either. Nom 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 nom. Alright guys, I'm quickly gonna eat this before it gets cold. And I wanna say thanks to everybody who hanged out today. Appreciate it a lot. As mentioned before, at the start of the stream, we're gonna raid Barb. Not sure, is she live yet? I think so. I'm actually doing it right now, but I haven't even checked if she's live already. Let's see. Did she start it? Yes, she started. All right, cool. She did. Whew. It's freaking hot, guys. Kami, Lindsay, Blaze, Dubbing. Everybody else who was lurking and twerking. I appreciate everybody watching the stream today. Sharing the foodie love. I'm going to go and eat this delicious meal right now. I'll upload this to YouTube as soon as possible for those who want to rewind.
want to watch it back. And we'll talk soon. Yeah. Let's make this official and cut to the ending screen. I'll talk to you guys later. Take care. Be safe. And most of all, stay chicken. Later, guys. Jamona's out.